This ministry was birthed when I was homeless, jobless, in deportation proceedings, suffered a partial heart failure. That is when God came to me to talk about this ministry. So this ministry was not birthed when I was on the mountaintop. It was when I was practically at the lowest ebb of my life. And the Spirit of God came to me. And he said, man of God, such that I will bring your way, I will use you to strengthen them. You can't come to this ministry and not be strengthened. It's impossible. He said, such that will come your way, I will use you to strengthen them. And I said, okay. And then I was assistant pastor in the Bronx, deliverance ministry in the Bronx. And it became apparent to everyone, the apostles, the bishops, that this man has been called on a different line. It just became apparent. And I did not want to go. I was comfortable in the house where I was. But I was released to start a ministry from scratch. And the ministry started in my living room. It was me, my wife, and my one-year-old daughter at the time. I started the ministry in my living room. And I'll be preaching to my wife and my one-year-old daughter. Oh. And then my wife will say, excuse me, I have to go change baby's pamper. And the sermon has to continue. And then God started to bring the people to our home, to our living room. And because we're in deliverance ministry, all kinds of people were coming to our house. They were manifesting in our house, manifesting in the kitchen. He said, oh, we have to move it from away from home. And then God took us to a place in Brooklyn called East New York. That is a war zone. The church we are staying in East New York, graffiti all over, inside and outside. We will come into the church. There will be no electricity. The bills have not been paid. And we were not responsible for the bills. And then I remember, I said in East New York, I said, before 2 months, I speak prophetically, we are moving out of here. And then when it was about 2 weeks to move, the evangelist, who was supposed to be here in the morning, he said to me, he said, Pastor, we only have 2 weeks. Remember what you said to the people? They are counting. I said, we still have 14 days, no problem.
Amen.
God can do it.
Amen.
And then the evangelist and I, we go on Fulton Streets in Brooklyn, that's a main street. And we kept asking the churches, can we rent from you? We know you do your service in the morning, we can do ours in the evening at 4 o'clock. Every church said no, 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 no. Until we got to the last church. When we got to the last church, the elderly lady opened the door. We said, oh, we are looking for church to rent. She said no. But her bishop was at the altar. And the bishop said, call them in. And we came before the bishop at the altar. He looked at us and he said, sit down! Like that. And he turned to the elderly lady, who was like 76 or 78. His younger sister. God begins to tell me his age. He said, you see these two men? These are the exact two men I told you about last week that the Lord showed to me. He said, I've been waiting for you. God told me you were coming. I said, really? He said, look at me, son. I'm in my 90s. If I tell you God said, he told me you are coming, that means he told me. I'm in my 90s. I don't have time to play games. So I have to correct myself. I just... He said, yes, what do you want? I said, we are looking for space to rent. He said, God said I should give you whatever you ask for. It is done. Now it comes to negotiating the rent. Fulton Street, for those of you coming from out of town, in Brooklyn, is like a major street. Where we were in East New York was like the backyard, you know? So in East New York, we are paying little rent. Like $500 a month. Because it was like an abandoned building and nobody wanted. So it was like $500 a month. So I said, sir, how much is the rent? He said, how much are you willing to pay? I said, I said, well, sir, where we are coming from? We are paying $500. Now, this part of Fulton Street, there's no way you will get it for less than $1,400. Those in Brooklyn, they are nodding their head. There's no way. I said, well, where we are coming from, we are paying $500. He said, you got it. I was about to say really again. So I said, sir, you know, I told my people that in another 2 weeks, we'll be moving out from where we are and we are coming to this place. He said, no. 2 weeks is too late. What if Jesus comes before 2 weeks? Starts today! So we have to explain to the old man, God bless him, he has gone to be with the Lord. We have to explain to the bishop that we need to give our people notice, we have to make announcements, we have to, you know, do other things. So reluctantly, we agreed. And as we were walking out, after signing the deal, he called me back. He said, young man, son, come back here. I came back. He said, let me warn you. I said, yes, sir. He said, anytime you can't pay the rent, don't go running helter-skelter looking for money to pay the rent. You just come to me and say, Bishop, I can't pay the rent, and that is okay. And then we outgrew that place and we came here. We outgrew that place and God brought us here. And when we came here, there were other people bidding for this commercial space. God give us favor again.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Everything they asked for, we were able to give. Because God used that back place in Fulton Street, where we are paying $500 a month, to build our financial reserves. Amen. So we had a big boost. Amen. So that when it was time to step into this place, dollar could not disqualify us.
Amen.
And the Spirit of God is still speaking that soon it will be time to move on. This is a ministry that transacts business in deep waters.
Amen.
Many nights my wife is praying till 2 a.m. If I look at my bed and I don't see her, I don't get to fight her. By the landing of our staircase, she's there. She has her seat there. And she's praying. Any power, by the covenant I have with Jesus Christ, any power that walks in through here, that power must be surrendered at the door.
Amen.
Amen.
It's not that witches have not tried us. It's not that strong men have not tried us. They have, all of them, fear.
Amen.
Because God is with us.
Amen.
In a summary, that's the testimony of our ministry.
Amen.
Let us move on to the word of God. We will get